Hello everyone, welcome to Affairs Cloud. On the 6th of March, the Union Government had constituted a Delimitation Commission for the states of Jammu and Kashmir, Assam, Arunachal Pradesh, Nagaland and Manipur. So, what is the Delimitation Commission? What will be the outcome of the constitution of Delimitation Commission for these states? Are all topics that we'll look into in the video. So, without delay, let's proceed to the video. On the 6th of March 2020, the Union Government had constituted a Delimitation Commission for the delimitation of the Assembly and Parliamentary constituencies of the Union Territory of Jammu and Kashmir and the NorthEastern states of Assam, Arunachal Pradesh, Manipur and Nagaland. This commission is headed by former Supreme Court Judge Ranjana Prakash Desai, Chief Election Commissioner Sushil Kumar Chandra and the Election Commissioners of the respective state governments, that is of Jammu and Kashmir, Assam, Arunachal Pradesh, Manipur and Nagaland, will be the ex officio members of the commission. So what is delimitation and what is the Delimitation Commission? So literally speaking, delimitation means the act or process of fixing limits or boundaries of territorial constituencies in a country or a province that has a legislative body. The job of delimitation is assigned to a high power body, and such a body in our country is known as the Delimitation Commission. In a few other territories, it's referred to as Boundary Commission. So let's move on to the objective of delimitation. So the main objective of delimitation is, on the basis of a recent census, the objective of delimitation is to redraw the boundaries of the various state assembly and Lok Sabha constituencies with the intention that there is equal representation as far as population is concerned from every state, every constituency, as far as it is practically possible. For instance, if a Lok Sabha constituency in Uttar Pradesh has a population of say 35 lakhs and another scarcely populated constituency in Chhattisgarh, a Lok Sabha constituency, has a population of say 60,000, then these two constituencies having the same value as far as the constituency value in Lok Sabha is concerned wouldn't lead to an equal outcome. So the intention of, or the objective of delimitation, is to ensure as far as practically possible that all constituencies have somewhat of a similar population. Also, another objective is to determine the number of seats, if any, to be reserved for the scheduled castes and scheduled tribes of the state. So, delimitation also has another objective where they have to enumerate the scheduled caste and scheduled tribe population and decide based on the numbers whether to increase, decrease or maintain the number of reserved constituencies for these communities. Also, delimitation attempts to properly divide geographical areas so that a political party does not get an unfair advantage over others in election. So this is also an objective of delimitation. And in the process of delimitation, the number of seats that have been allocated to different states in Lok Sabha and the total number of seats in a legislative assembly may also change. For example, Tamil Nadu currently has 39 constituencies in the Lok Sabha and 234 constituencies in the state assembly. So if a delimitation commission is implemented in Tamil Nadu, these numbers may change. Now let's look at the constitutional provisions of the Delimitation Commission and the Delimitation Act. So under Article 82 of the Indian Constitution, the Parliament enacts a Delimitation Act after every census, national census. And then under Article 170, the states get divided into territorial constituencies as per Delimitation Act after every national census. And once the Delimitation Act is in force, the Union Government constitutes a Delimitation Commission, and this commission demarcates, that is, marks the boundaries of the constituencies as per provisions of the Delimitation Act of 2002. So now let's take a look at the Delimitation Commission and its framework and features. So the commission is appointed by the President of India and it works in collaboration with the Election Commission of India. Every Delimitation Commission is composed of a retired Supreme Court judge as the chairperson of the commission and the Chief Election Commissioner along with the respective state election commissioners as the ex officio members of the commission. Now looking at the features of the Delimitation Commission, the commission in India is a high power body whose orders have the force of law and cannot be called in question in any before any court. So what this means is that essentially the submission of the Delimitation Commission cannot be put before question in any court of law. Also, the copies of its orders are laid before the House of the People, that is the Lok Sabha and the state legislative assemblies, but neither the Lok Sabha nor the state legislative assemblies are allowed to make any modifications to the orders that have been presented by the commission. In case of difference of opinion within the commission, among the members of the commission, that is, the opinion of the majority will prevail. So these are the features of the Delimitation Commission. Now looking at previous delimitation exercises, delimitation commissions have been set up four times in the past in independent India. So these were in 1952, 1963, 1973 and 2002 under the Delimitation Commission Acts of the respective years. Now an interesting and important point to be noted here is that the Union Government had suspended delimitation in 1976 until after the 2001 census, that is from 1976 until the completion of 2001 census. And the reason behind this was the family planning program in different states and its effect on the state's population, which would affect their political representation in the Lok Sabha. Now this decision to suspend the delimitation had adverse effects where it led to wide discrepancies in the population size of different constituencies, such that this had led to such a difference that the largest of the constituencies in terms of number of voters was in the range of 30 lakhs and the smallest of the constituencies in terms of number of voters was in the range of 50,000, which has a ratio of 60:1. So this is a very skewed ratio and very contrary to the intention or the objective behind delimitation. So now with regards to the problems with delimitation, if you recall, the intention or the objective behind delimitation is to demarcate constituencies in such a way that all constituencies have a similar population. Now the consequence of this is that states that take little interest in population control or have very high fertility rates could end up with a much greater number of seats in parliament. And the other side of this is that certain states that promoted family planning or had very good family planning schemes, for example the southern states, also face the possibility of having their seats reduced. Also, increase in population is not accounted for and are being still represented by a single representative. This is also another problem with delimitation, with the cap on the number of Lok Sabha seats. Also, in 2008, delimitation was done based on the 2001 census, but the total number of seats in the assemblies and parliament was decided as per the 1971 census and this was not changed. So this is an example of a problem with delimitation. Now with regards to the future of the Delimitation Act and the Delimitation Commission, the present delimitation of parliamentary constituencies has and had been done on the basis of the 2001 census figures under the provisions of the Delimitation Act of 2002. But the Constitution of India was specifically amended in 2002 and the amendment was to not have delimitation of constituencies until after the census of 2026. Now, the reasoning behind this amendment was given that our country would achieve a uniform population growth throughout by the time of 2026. And hence, the present constituencies that are carved out on the basis of the 2001 census shall continue to remain so in operation until after the census of 2026. Now, coming back to our original topic, that is regarding the planned delimitation exercise in the states of Jammu Kashmir and the four northeastern states, the commission is mandated to delimit the Lok Sabha and the assembly constituencies in Jammu and Kashmir under the provisions of the Jammu and Kashmir Special Reorganization Act of 2019. So this is a very important point to be noted. And under this act, the two new union territories of Jammu and Kashmir, so as we all know, after the abrogation of Article 370, the state of Jammu and Kashmir was split into three union territories, two union territories of Jammu and Kashmir with a legislative assembly and one of Ladakh without a legislative assembly. And the delimitation in Jammu and Kashmir will be based on the census of 2011 due to an amendment in the Jammu and Kashmir Reorganization Act of 2019. Now, as far as Assam, Arunachal Pradesh, Manipur and Nagaland are concerned, the provisions of the Delimitation Act of 2002 will be used for the delimitation exercise, and it will be based on the 2001 census in these states. The Section 60 of the Jammu and Kashmir Reorganization Act of 2019 stipulates that the number of seats in its legislative assembly will be increased from 107 to 114, and out of these, 24 seats have been reserved for Pakistan occupied Kashmir, POK. So this is a very noteworthy point. Also, the latest delimitation in other parts of India has been carried out as per the census of 2001. So this is also something to be noted. Thank you for watching the video. I hoped you liked our video. Please leave your feedback in the form of comments, and please remember to subscribe to our channel. See you in the next video.